Okay, RCW and policy requirements, we're looking at sale of Clallam County, sale to Clallam County for a right-of-way improvement. This is so that the county can widen the lower Elwha Road. We own property that is alongside of that road, and they have prepared paperwork and appraisal and such to pay for purchasing a portion of that right-of-way. The process for the sale of port property is detailed in RCW 53.08.090 as follows. A port district may sell and convey any of its real or personal property valued at more than $10,000 when the Port Commission has, by resolution, declared the property to be no longer needed for district purposes. But no property which is a part of the comprehensive plan of improvement or modification thereof shall be disposed of until the comprehensive plan has been modified to find the property surplus to port needs. Comprehensive plan shall be modified only after public notice and hearing provided by RCW 53.20.010. The process for the sale of the airport property shown in Exhibit A of the airport layout plan is detailed in the Federal Aviation Administration National Policy Order 5190.6B. In summary, the sponsor, the port, is federally obligated to obtain FAA consent to sell or dispose of airport property. Background. Clallam County is interested in purchasing the port-owned property identified as the Lower Elwha Road. The subject property is at 1 acre and approximately 1,450 feet long. Clallam County is preparing to reconstruct a portion of the Lower Elwha Road. To complete the reconstruction of the subject property is needed as a county right-of-way. Analysis, the subject property was purchased in the 1980s utilizing federal grant funding to support airport operations at the William R. Fairchild International Airport. The proposed use of subject property under the ownership of Clallam County for a public road right-of-way will maintain the same benefits to the airport as the inner safety and inner turning zone The FAA Seattle Airports District has granted the release of the subject property. Attached Resolution 16-1129 modifies the port's comprehensive scheme of harbor improvements to find the subject property surplus to port needs and declares the subject property to be no longer needed by the port district purposes. Environmental impact. The port CEQA responsible official has evaluated these procedural actions and found the procedural actions to be categorically exempt from CEPA environmental review in accordance with WAC 197-819. Clallam County issued a CEPA determination of non-significance for the proposed roadwork environmental modification on November 2, 2015. Fiscal impact, the proposed sale of the subject property will result in $22,000 from the county that will port will apply to the operation and prioritized long-term capital improvements at the William R. Fairchild International Airport. The county provided an appraisal report which staff reviewed and determined was to be appropriate.
I have a question on the $22,000 that we received. Is there any restrictions to that money? Does it have to stay within the airport?
I'll go on with recommended action. The commission is to open the public hearing to hear testimony on the following. Modify the port comprehensive scheme of harbor improvements to find a subject property surplus to port needs and declares the subject property be no longer needed for port district purposes.
I have one question. It says the process for the sale of airport property shown in Exhibit A is detailed in the FAA National Policy Order, etc. So the FAA has already approved this?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Well, I'm noting that I'm wondering if there is
any significance to the fact that we are identifying the price of this, the property in this area near our airport as being valued at $22,000 per acre? And will there be any future?
I would say no, because this is a very unique shaped piece of property.
Right.
And so, you know, the county is actually the one who provided the appraisal on this.
But in the absence of comps, I just wonder if there's, and yeah, you're right, there's.
Because of its use on a right of way, that when it's the value of the property, and I think we can point to that as a distinguishing factor.
Mm-hmm.
Because otherwise the property is really just part of our area that we need to keep, they have a clear zone around the airport.
When, gosh, more than a decade ago now, we sold, what, 40 acres to the entity that created the, yeah, the sprint racing. We don't know how much that was for. No, it wasn't, correct. It was just, but I'm saying, I think that was the recent kind of similar comp. And I'm actually thinking about the abrogation easement at the, which, in which case we would want to point to the lower rate.
I think in the valuation, it's always looked at as its highest and best use and existing use. So I do think this has a limited flexibility because it isn't right of way.
Mm-hmm.
If.
Mm-hmm.
Easement.
Sure. Okay. It was just discussion.
Well, I'd make a motion that we open public hearing to hear testimony on the following: to modify the port's comprehensive scheme of harbor improvements to find the subject property surplus to the port needs, and declares the subject property be no longer needed for port district purposes.
Okay, so at this time I will open the public hearing to provide an opportunity to hear testimony and public comment, if there is any. So if there is no public comment, then we will move along to closing the public hearing. So at this time, I'm now closing the public hearing.
So we make a motion to introduce resolution 16-1129 as presented.
Second. Okay, we've got an introduction of resolution 16-1129. Is there any discussion? Okay, hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay, and the motion carries unanimously, so therefore we can, at this point, I'll accept a motion to adopt resolution 16-1129.
So moved.
Second. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, and the motion to adopt resolution 16-1129 is approved unanimously.
So I will move to authorize the interim executive director to sell the subject property to Clallam County for a sale price of $22,000.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Okay, hearing none. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. And the motion carries unanimously. From our end, that was an easy sale. I'm sure on your